Let learning be a joy and teaching a pleasure. Children, today we are going to study about the 9th chapter of science, disaster management. Now, disaster means a natural calamity. Now, today we are going to study first about earthquake. Now, what is an earthquake? An earthquake is generally a tremor which is being caused by the sudden vibrations felt due to the shaking of the earth's surface or the ground. And generally, these earthquakes are caused due to the seismic waves and the vibrations cause surface of the earth to go up and down. And this resulting shocks and the waves formed in the interior of the earth spread on the surface in all directions. Now, coming to the central point of the earthquake. Now, generally, when I'm talking about this central point of the earthquake, it is the point above the epicenter on the earth's surface. And a major loss will be observed near this area. Now, coming to the types of shocks of the earthquake, there are two types. One is mild and the second is intensified. Shocks which are in more frequency and the destruction is less, that is referred to as mild shocks, and the intensified, generally the frequency of the shocks will be less but the destruction will be more. Now, coming to the next topic, that is seismograph. Now, what is seismograph? Now, generally the earthquakes which are being noticed on several parts of the earth, according to the observation of the National Earthquake Information Center, nearly 12,400 to 14,000 earthquakes occur on the earth. And seismograph is the instrument which records the earthquakes, and Richter scale is the mathematical measure to understand the intensity of earthquake. Now, coming to the causes of the earthquake, first coming to natural causes, volcanic eruptions. Steam formed inside the interior of the earth tries to come out on the earth's surface, and the causes which are caused due to the actions on the human beings. That is, the first one is underground atomic test, mining, and the pressure due to mega hydroelectric projects and dams. Now, coming to the effects of the earthquake, loss of human beings, wild animals and pets, economic loss at a large scale, ecosystem destruction due to the loss of biodiversity, direction of the flow of the rivers, streams changes, and the possibility of fire in cities increases. Now, coming to the precautions which should be taken, that is, which should be taken, and for example, the do's at home. Not to get scared and to run here and there. We should stand silently at one place and we should sit on the ground under the table. Outside home, if traveling in the vehicle, park your vehicle at a safe place and be inside the vehicle. We should avoid waiting below the tall buildings, trees, or the electric pole. Now, coming to the don'ts. Don'ts means which we should not do during the earthquake. Not to use the elevator at the time of the earthquake. Do not sit in an uncomfortable position for a long time. Do not be motionless for a long time. Turn off the main circuit, and instead of using the candles, lantern, use the torches. Now, coming to the earthquake resistant buildings. The earthquake resistant buildings are constructed with the idea that even if there is some movement of the earth, the building should not get damaged. And the Indian Standard Institute has made some code of conduct to construct these tall buildings. Now, to get the prior information about the earthquake, modern equipments like laser ranging, giger counter, creep meter, strain meter, tilt meter is being used for this reason. Now coming to the types of fire. Class A fire, Class B fire, Class C, Class D and Class E fire. Now in the first category, that is Class A fire, flammable materials like wood, clothes, coal, papers are their fuel source and this fire can be put out with water. Class B fire, fire is caused due to flammable liquid substances like petrol, oil, varnish, solvents and all these substances are lighter than water and since it is lighter than water, fire extinguishers are used to extinguish the fire. Class C fire, fires caused due to acetylene household gas. Class D fire, combustible metals like potassium, sodium and calcium react with water at normal temperature and metals like magnesium, aluminium and zinc react with water at the higher temperature. Explosion occurs when these two groups combine with each other. Then coming to the Class E fire, electrical components, etc. Thank you.